We thank God for this day. We bless His holy name. Lord, we invite you that come and take dominion of everything. Come and take absolute control. We invite your presence. Without your presence, we can never do anything. Lord, we thank you for answering our prayers for Jesus Christ in His name. Amen. Yes, today we are coming to talk about don't love the world. Don't love the world. When you turn your Bibles to 1 John 2:15, is there something there? 1 John 2:15. It says, do not love the world or anything that belongs to the world. If you love the world, you do not love the Father. But many Christians of nowadays, we are loving the world. We are taking the world to Lagala. We have taken the world to be our master, our everything. But I assure you that if we love the world, know that the kingdom of heaven is not for you. Just repent. Repent from those things. Repent from those things. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. The Bible says that repent for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. In the book of Mark 1:15, in the book of Matthew 3:2, the book of Matthew 4:17, in the book of Matthew 10:7, oh la garabarabasa, the Lord, la 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 la, the word of God says something in the book of John 3:16, say that for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish but have eternal life. So why is it that Christian, we say that we believe in Christ, but at the end we will perish? That means we are not believing Him. We are not doing what He wants us to do. But now I assure you that we have to do what He wants us to do. James chapter 4 verse 4 says, he says that unfaithful people, don't you know that to be the world's friend means to be God's enemy? People want to be the ones who make themselves God's enemy. It means that if you become a friend of the world, you become an enemy of God. How will you enter His kingdom? Never. You will perish in the lake of fire. The lake of fire is sweet. Heaven is sweet and earth is sweet. Repent from all these worldly things and be saved. Let's go to the book of Ephesians chapter 4. Yes. Ephesians chapter 4 verse 31 says something. Also, get rid of all bitterness, passion and anger. No more shouting or insults. No more hurtful feelings of any sort. Verse 32 says, instead, be kind and tender-hearted to one another and forgive one another as God has forgiven you through Christ. As God has forgiven you, you to forgive one another.